tired and saggy. And also, she has a very harsh look. She looks angry. So putting all the planning that I did before, I will start putting together the code plus the active numbers. And I'm going to do this as fast as I can so that we finish on time. Can you zoom in on her, please? Now, starting with something very important. Look, I tilt her down, I ask her to resume her level. So, marking the junction between the lower eyelid and the cheek. So, both sides. Toujours, en face de toi. Ici, look. Marking the junction. Because of her Asian ethnicity, please observe that her CK2 presents the malar mouth. Look. So, I cannot inject in her malar mouth. And I mark both sides. This is the no-go area. So because of this width that she presents, take a look how important the temple area is, very sunken both sides. So my idea to improve is to put what I discussed. Look, I start by injecting CK1, and I will show where CK1 is. CK1 is the cheek coat that we always start. I feel the fusion. Can we put the coats there, please? Then I mark 3 points. Because her CK2 is not possible to inject, we can after inject a more posterior CK2. So we create 3 anchoring points in CK1 plus 1 anchoring point in CK2 posteriorly. However, she also is empty in CK4. So when I follow the rule of 0307 in the active numbers, can I take a look at the active numbers 0307? This is what I'm starting to inject. I ask her, ferme les yeux. So I clean. Take a look. I start with 0101 prime. And retract the skin. And then inject where the black dot was. Aspirate and inject 0.1. I do the same in the anterior dot. And then I do the last one. Always touching the bone, creating a bolus. So what I want to achieve. Look, 0.3 were injected. Is it visible, Kun?
Yes.
Okay, good. Now, let's very briefly see. This was her worst side. As you remember, zoom out. And I started trying to zoom out a little bit more. That's it. I'm starting seeing that she's becoming less asymmetric, if you remember when I saw. So, if I have the rule 0.3, I can put 0.7 in CK4. And I mark the inferior margin of the zygomatic arch, and I see where the concavity lies, where the shadow lies. So I mark this full area, which is named after CK4. So CK4 is to be injected into the subcutaneous. I ask her to close her eyes, clean. And in this area, especially in Asians, we may see some retractions, and I tell the patient that she may feel some crack sound. I enter with a 23 gauge needle. I always try to open and widen the orifice, and I have 1 cc here, look. But I have to go down to 0.3, so that 0.7 is going to be injected in total. Now, fanning very gently. Always more lateral as I can. What I'm trying to obtain is lateral pulling of the cheek with CK1 and CK4. These are named after the lateral lifters of the face. So when I reach down to 0.3, I will have already injected 1 ml on her right hand side. So this is a session that I try to give her more symmetry. Let's look. I don't know if it's visible, but I see that now she got slimmer already.
Yeah.
And take a look what happened with the red marking. And if you look, take a look the lateral canthal area. You see, she presents a slight scleral show, and on the other side, she is more tilted up. She's very difficult for us because she has tattoo in her brows, tattoo in her eyes, and also tattoo in her lips. And you see the proportion of her nose and also in her face. This is a challenging case. Now, she has a very important sunken temple. So, if I'm going to address, the active number for T1 is 1 ml at 0.5, okay? The minimal dose that I inject in T1. But as it's so sunken and all of her right hand side is worse than the left, I will inject now 1 cc. So, I ask the patient to slightly open her mouth to relax. Open your mouth. Ouvre la bouche un petit peu, relaxer. Non, pas si tôt. Oui. So, I ask her to open her mouth so that she can relax temporalis. Now, cleaning. Then I have a full syringe. I try to escape the vessels. I usually protect the superficial temporal artery with my thumb. And I retract to escape the vessels. Touch the bone, aspirate. And I start injecting slowly. This is the time where I tell patients that she may feel a pressure. Vous pouvez sentir une pression, c'est normal, ok? Ouvre la bouche un petit peu. Oui. So, and why asking her to open her mouth? Because if she does so, we will have less discomfort during the injection. Zoom out a little bit more. So when we do T1, in reality, I'm expanding this mass. The superficial muscular aponeurotic system. And by doing this, enabling myomodulation. So we see changes not only at the site of the injection, but as well as distantly, indirect effect. So I expect by injecting a full syringe in T1 that I see less concavity, so no bleeding, but I also expect that she's getting slimmer and slimmer. So let's see. See that? Take a look when she looks. Look at that. You see that time by time, we see much less concavity. However, this is a black hole, right? So to be able to do, I will try to do the same now in a faster way, right? So that I can try to finish in the given time. So I did 2 syringes on her right hand side. I will put the same on the left, the very, very same. So I will start finding the suture of the zygomatic arch. Then I go anteriorly and posteriorly. So 0.1, do not cross the marking. And after injecting 0.7, along CK4, the 2 lateral vectors. If you notice this strategy, I used CK1 as a lateral vector, CK4 and T1. I'm trying to bring everything lateral. Let's go down and maintenant l'autre côté, ok? Comme ça, ferme les yeux. So, cleaning. I have, take a look, I'm using the same syringe as I started. I have 0.7 here, right? Is it visible, Kuhn?
Yes.
Then I will go down to 0.4, okay? So we can use the same touch, aspirate, and inject 0.1. As I do not change the position, I do not contaminate, I inject, continue injecting if she does not bleed. If she bleeds, I have to stop bleeding and clean again. So take a look. Exactly 0.3 were injected, and basically I proceed with CK4 with 0.7 with Voluma, and I get a new syringe only to be faster. Look, cleaning, and what's very important is to avoid, I try to avoid the cannula to touch the skin. Look, I have here a full syringe of 1 ml, I have my assistants to hold this for me, I clean again, pinch, enter the 23 gauge needle, make a round movement so that we can widen the orifice, and proceed with injecting CK4, the lateral vector, with 0.7. I always tell people, because of the proximity of the ear, that she's gonna hear a crack sound. Tu vas sentir un bruit, c'est normal. But she should not feel pain. So initially, when I have a patient that I'm going to treat full face, as is the case, I don't mind the asymmetry initially, because I take the opportunity to correct it in the refinement. 0.3 left. Visible?
Yes.
Good. Perfect. Now, I have to stop slightly to stop the bleeding. Hold this for me. While I move to the other side and inject one syringe, a full syringe in T1. So, can take this off, please? Again, the same strategy. Okay, take off. Put a cotton tube. Hold it here for me like this. Can you zoom in here, please? Only the temples met. That's good. So, cleaning. Maintenant, je veux appliquer ici, okay? Ouvre la bouche. I ask her to relax. You know, it's her first time. You see that she's very nervous. By the way, she's fainting. She's afraid of needles, by the way. So, protecting the artery. Then, take a look. Aspiration. And inject. It's the first time I'm getting this new syringe. And it's really incredible, because it gives me much more comfort to aspirate. So it is something that really makes me feel relaxed now.
So if they can show you when you do that, well, not now, but next time with aspiration, if you have the syringe, it would be pleasant to see that how your fingers are able to do this.
Sure, I'll ask them. So very slowly. Vou ver o filho se eu sinto dor. Vou falar com você. Isso é mato, meu Deus. Ok. So, very slowly. Very slowly. Then, take out, no bleeding. Sometimes it bleeds, and the only thing I do, I make a pressure. So, I have already. Now I'm gonna zoom out. I'm gonna clean out. And I could continue working on her cheeks. Right? This would be session number one. I did 4 syringes. Okay? Ferme les yeux. Now, there are many options. I could continue. And I could go to the lower face. Now I will go to C1, C2, because I believe, as I start, look at the camera now, as I started making her more symmetrical, now it's time for me to address her marionette lines. I could go to CK3, it's okay, you know? This is something that we can very easily do, or we go to C1, C2. In her case, I will improve a little bit mid-face, now I go to contour lower face. So, the strategy was foundation mid-face, contour upper face, contour lower face. Now, I ask her, Est-ce que c'est possible de faire comme ça? So she opens the labial mental angle. I try to fix the midline. Then I create the belt of C1. And in C1, I have to inject down to subcutaneous. And it gives also support for the lower leg and the chin. So can you put the active numbers? I identified C1 and C2. Now I have the 0.7 and 0.3. This is my syringe number one of the second session. I have already two syringes per site. Then I go with C1 and C2 cleaning. This is an area that usually we have a lot of vessels and the patients may feel a little bit of discomfort. Net non peut faire un petit peu mal. Now enter, open the orifice, the same thing, and I get voluma with the cannula, and I inject an enterograde fanning very slowly to create support, not only for the lower leg, but also to advance slightly the chin. You can zoom out. So I'm trying to inject slowly so that she does not feel pain. I look at the pain with her eyes. So if I see her squinting, this is because I'm going too fast. Then I go slower because the lidocaine that contains in volume is incredibly fast. Now look. I have 0.3 left, and I have to change direction with the cannula. When I go towards C2, please observe that I will not change the position of the cannula, but I will only feel the bolus expanding in C2. This will help increasing the vertical height of the chin and possibly make her look less square and more angular. So once you see, I go to the other one, other side.
Can I help you here from you, please?
Now I turn. And I try to escape the vessel sphere. If she's, you can take it out now. You use a cotton bud, cotton tip. Okay, cleaning. Take out. So C1, the same thing that I did beforehand. This is a 25-inch cannula. I also asked the patient to slightly open the mouth, and the reason is I want to release mentalis contraction so that she feels less discomfort. And I'm counting as I'm progressing about the improvement. Very slowly. So that I can control if she feels discomfort. As I told you, this is her first time and she's afraid of needles. Now take a look. 0.3 left. Neurotically, and I go towards C2. I don't change, move the camera. Only my hands to feel if the product is expanding properly, if I'm having an even injection. Something else? Okay? So, this is my syringe. Number two, session number two, okay? So, something that I usually do that I find very appropriate is to improve the under chin skin excess. But for this, I usually use JW4 and JW5, look. So, interestingly, these two points These two codes, they changed the way I approach. And if you remember the case I presented before, this is a way that we can really improve the under chin skin excess by lateral expansion. So there are also the active numbers. If you look at the active numbers, it's 0.5 as the minimal dose if I ever touch JW4. And you know something that I was reflecting to? I think fillers should be like Vistabel and antibiotics. We cannot underdose. So this thing that we put a little bit here, a little bit there, may look a great result initially, but does not last. And patients that they are investing, they want duration. So that's why, for me, if I touch a coat, I give the minimal dosing, which is the active number, just like going to glabella. If you go to glabella, 20 units, period. If you go to CrossFit, 12 units per side, period. Look, 0.5. Then I go towards JW5. Okay? And JW5 is slightly under C2. And the idea here is to advance the mandible, creating the structure. Okay? Now I'm going to the other side and do the same. Can you come here, please? Tá filmado? Que é fantástico, né? Se ela for minha fone, então... Then, escaping the vein here that's visible. Le côté gauche, c'est toujours, ça fait toujours plus mal. It's interesting. Patients usually complain more on her left. So, I also can guide with my fingers. So, as much as I'm injecting, I'm trying to see how much I'm proceeding. And everything can come, sorry.
Yes.
Everything was already calculated, you understand? So I see four syringes, session number one, four syringes, session number two, yeah. Four syringes. So this is how I try to deliver surgical results or similar, an alternative to surgery for our patients, obeying each code with the active number.
Yeah.
So this is as we end up by changing what was something common like chasing lines and folds before towards something that has more structure, foundation, contour to our patients. So now I'm happy. I finished session number two with another four syringes. Then I can go and proceed with mid-face again. Okay, so now, take a look. Now it's time for me to address her mid-chin area. Take a look. We see, can you zoom out, please? We see that her neck is already improved. And zoom in her eyes. Chin down again. I mark her. It's the same thing. I mark the junction. Always, toujours, and then I mark the noble area. Take a look. This eminence, right? The malama looks too big because it is too much deflated. Then I come and I mark. So the question for me here is simple. I have to look at her. I mark the mid popliteal line, right? Then I have to find the projection of the infraorbital foramen, both sides, right? So I could go with a needle and try to expand it, look. But when I look at her in her full profile, her nose is not too high. So I don't want excessive projection. So my choice, not only for projection, but also for caution in CK3, is to use a large area, but I need to advance. I need to advance for mid-phase because she's retreated. And I will inject this full area with a camera and volume, 0.5, 0.5. So the active numbers now is 0505, fanning, triangle, the same strategy, pinch, enter, and 25 gauge camera. As this can be a sensitive area, I'm already injecting when I proceed. So this is the syringe number one of session number three. I'm injecting and I'm already calculating how much. I always try to protect the eye, so I'm really injecting the deep molar fat bed under orbicularis ocula. And this will help the eye to get more open. So 0.5. And this is how I notice zoom out, if the correction was proper or if I still need a little bit more, you see? It's deficient. So I went already with volume, I may go to the other side first and go back if needed. That's
too much. It is very obvious.
It's getting obvious, right? Now, pinch, enter, circle movement, look, 0.5. Always protecting the orbit area. This is a film the cotecution. Very gentle in the deep molar fat bed. Very gentle.
Which are this deep middle fat fat?
Yeah. I'm trying to get as deep as I can, not hitting the infraorbital.
Half cc each time.
Yeah. Now this was syringe number one. So I will look at her and I see what has happened. But I still notice that she's still depleted. Then, as I want to give optimal correction for her, I'll go back in CK3 and I will inject now full lift into the needle soup. I'll see if she can handle this so that you can take a look in another view. With camera. Never go into the tear trough. Feel in again. Back in the soup. It's the same area. The only difference now is I am more superficial, but it's still under orbicularis ocula. Trying to treat the suborbicularis ocular effect. So CK3 is an interesting area. We can address this down to the bone, deep molar fat bed, as well as the medial soup. Then I go to the other side. That one is you. Very gentle. It's interesting that even asymmetric patients, when we deliver the same amount, because of volume expansion, they all look less asymmetric. So that's why I do not go towards static asymmetry at rest, only if it's dynamic. So this was my syringe number 2 of the third session. Agreed?
Yeah, absolutely.
That's good. I still have a lot to accomplish. I'm going to inject. Now, NL1, because of her widening of her nasal flare. So I will get full lumen in her case, because I have to touch the bone. And I will try to bring the nose a little bit outwards. So volume with needle. There are a rule with the MD codes. Never inject a bolus bigger than 0.3. Although there are exceptions, like T1 and JW1. So can you zoom out a little bit? Cleaning. So this area, we have to aspirate properly. Can you go to the camera, not here, show more up? Yeah. I'll show you the injection if, let me see if it's, okay. Can you zoom out a little bit more? That's it.
Perfect.
Yeah, this is a little bit tricky for me because I don't have support, okay? Then a prime. 1 mL, then I enter, look, deep to the bone, aspirate.
That's very obvious that this becomes very easy to do.
It's very easy.
Yeah.
Because aspirating with one hand is challenging,
yeah.
Especially it depends on the size of the hand in reality. But even though if you want to really create negative pressure, I always tell people that they have to see the bubble. Visible that 0.3 was injected. And I don't know if it's clear there. Take a look already the change in the position of the nasal flare. You see that with NL1 that's injected, we ended up by giving a slightly support for the nasal flare, which is good for her. So, not the same syringe. Clean.
She's slimming, so, and lifting.
Yeah.
The more anterior projection of the nose.
Yeah, true. Mm-hmm. Down to the bone. Aspirate and inject 0.3. So I have to leave 0.4 in the syringe. This, when we use NL1 and Voluma, we have to go down to the bone, okay? 0.4. So, this was syringe number
3.
But I still have 0.4 here, agreed? What I'm gonna do, I will go to C2 midline to create a more triangular chin, which is desirable when we have a wide face. So, close your eyes. I cannot inject more than 0.3 per bolus, so I'm gonna go 0.3 deep to the bone. I will withdraw the needle and I will inject 0.1 in a more superficial plane, so that in this way I obey the rule. Can you zoom in, please? So I try to put the hand in position, so show more the neck now, it's okay? Look, enter, this is painful, touch the bone, aspirate, and inject 0.3 without moving the needle. So when I get after 0.3, I withdraw, then I inject 0.1 in a different compartment. Now, this was syringe number 3. My syringe number for the last one of the session is going to go back to nasolabial folds. And I will go now with a more superficial plane with volt lift. How much time I have?
Actually, 3 minutes.
No way, really?
But I think we can go up to 5.
Really? What time did I start?
It is now 5:20.
No, I know, but what? I don't think I'm here for...
Doesn't matter, you can
I
go
don't
on.
Think I'm here for 40 minutes already, that's why.
Yeah, I've been explaining a lot, Mauricio.
Okay. Okay, so now let's go to nasolabial fold. Can you hold this, please, with a cotton tip? Zoom in here, please. Now, different perspective. I get volt lift. Clean. And inject half a syringe per side. Can you please zoom out? Take off this. What I'm going to do, when I have only half a syringe per side, I usually inject only, zoom out please. I want to see the product. 0.3 mm1 and 0.2 mm2, so half syringe per side. To give support. And this is also will help with our nose indirectly. 0.5. And zoom out everything now. Just full of challenging tedious. Dry gauze. Inject it very slowly. Very, very fine. Okay, so this was session number 3 done. Now it's time I go to session number 4, next session. In session number 4, can you stop the video here? I will address her lips. And her lips are very important because she wears the tube and I lost more or less a perimeter. That's why it's so tough for us in this reality. But can you zoom in a bit, please? What for me is the challenge? Zoom out a little. Is this inversion that she presents? So I will start with whole lift by creating a tiny inversion laterally first. So I will go with a cannula and then I have a the active number already. I have 0.2 in LP1 superscript, which is upper lip, 0.2 LP1 subscript, and 0.1 in LP6. I will concentrate 0.5 all around the upper and the lower lip initially. Maintenant, ça peut faire un petit peu mal. Okay, cleaning, enter, so go retrograde, intergrade. Is there something wrong to love to you? Ouvre la bouche un petit peu. So I'm injecting intergrade, look, trying very gently to create support. After inject 0.8, I go to the lower lip, LP1 subscript. And I try, look, to create also eversion. Okay, my pain. So, You see, I have 0.6 in the syringe. Is it feasible there?
Yes, very good.
Then I go back to LP6, the orocomsul deep plane. Okay, 0.5. Let me go to the other side, and I'll do the same. Ça va?
Lady is very brave.
She's brave. For her first time, it's
incredible. Yeah, absolutely. It's remarkable.
And she's afraid of needles, she told me yesterday. Try to evert. Look, 0.3. Lower it now. Now 0.1 left. Then the orocomsul, deep tissue, deep compartment. So now, one cc was injected in her lip, which is not enough at all. So now I get saline. Do you have saline? La bouche va être bizarre maintenant à cause de la anesthésie, la lidocaine. So then, I find very important when I use cannulas, ufolation. So to do this light massage. Okay? Now, it's getting better, but I still need more volume. So I go with another syringe now. Now I have 0.2 full lip, 0.2 lower, and another 0.1 in the orocomsul. You see, she's so depleted and deflated. That's why I need to create volume. So look, new syringe, zoom out. So I have to get now to the middle part. Take a look, 0.8. Clean. Then I go to the lower leg. Very gentle. Then I have 0.6 left. Then I go back to the orocomsul. Finishing exactly with 0.5. Go back to the other side. So, cleaning?
Yeah. Beautiful.
I'm never afraid to, can you clean again, please? I'm never afraid to inject whole lip in the lips. It's truly. It really gives me control. Can you clean again? Now I'm going LP1, checking until I get 0.3. Then I go to the lower lip.
What is it? That's the same level as you did before, huh?
Yeah. I'm inflating her lips. Then I go to deep puncture. So now, cannula, saline, and I can go with LP6 with volet 0.5%. See that? So, I have this C6, and I put 0.5 per side with full lift, mainly in the upper part. I'll try to get to the symmetry point as JW4. Trying to bring out the retrusion of the...
Richard, I see that it's a little bit more difficult to get the cannula through there. That's of the mandibular ligament, huh?
Yeah, and also because I entered with the needle towards the anterior. I'm trying to, you know, when they don't bleed, I try to use the same entry point.
Do you agree by releasing the ligament there, by softening it, you have a better lift of the corner of the mouth?
You know, I try to create as minimal trauma as possible myself.
Yeah.
If I have to address a very tight ligament, I go with needles down to the bone rather than creating this kind of subincision.
Gives me the impression that the lady is clotted very easily and
which is good that she doesn't need it. We would also need Mobella and also more in the oral commissure, but you know, because of time, I can do this off camera. Okay, so I will just wait a little bit, and let's try to see the